Hi guys, my name is Ellie. I'm the senior recruiter here at Dacha Real Estate, and today I'm joined with Darrell, who is our sales and leasing manager. So Darrell, thanks for sitting down with me. How are you?
I'm very good, thank you. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good, thank you. Good. Not bad. I thought it'd be the perfect opportunity to sit down with you after celebrating 8 years at Dacha last week.
8 years, long time.
Very long time. And I've got 8 questions for you for 8 years.
Good idea. Let's go.
For those who don't know you, could you tell us a little bit about your background and how you got into real estate?
Yeah, sure. So I actually fell into real estate by accident. I was in construction before, believe it or not. Me in construction just doesn't seem right. But I got made redundant from my jobs in construction. Ended up speaking to a lady who owned a very small family-run real estate company or estate agency in the UK. Mm-hmm. The office was only 2 or 3 people. Got offered the job there, and instantly fell in love with the job, the industry, the people, the rewards from it financially. Everything about it was just super exciting for me. So yeah, not really looked back since then. That was 20 years ago.
Amazing. Wow.
Long time, yeah.
Wow, very long time. And how would you say that your role has evolved over the last 8 years here at Dacha?
Yeah, at Dacha, for those that don't know, I actually joined Dacha as the recruitment manager. I had your job. But it was also because of my experience before I joined Dacha, I was also heavily involved in the training as well as the recruitment. Mm-hmm. And kind of organically over the years, positions have come up where the company has grown. So I went from recruitment manager to operations and training to the leasing manager, and then sales and leasing manager. So it's taken some time, but over the years I've again organically kind of grown my role within Dacha at the same time as kind of Dacha's also been growing. So it's been good, it's been a good journey.
Yeah, amazing, wow. And what would you say that is the most significant achievement in your career so far?
For me personally, or? Okay, so I guess there's two parts of that question. So for me personally, naturally, the move from starting as a leasing agent in the UK to now leading a team of 35 agents, mm-hmm. is obviously the super rewarding for me, and I'm very happy and proud of what I've achieved in that time. It's a lot of hard work, blood, sweat, tears, literally, yeah. Over the years, but yeah, I certainly wouldn't change it. So that's been super rewarding. I guess more recently, and I guess since now leading the team, my rewards come from seeing people that join. Some of them come with experience, some of them don't, but then growing to be, you know, or turning into, you know, superstar real estate agents is nice.
Yeah, no, definitely. And how would you say, obviously over the last 8 years, how would you say you stay motivated in your role?
Again, honestly, I think that's easy. I don't need anyone to motivate me. I'm a self-motivated person. So regardless of the situation, whether it's good or bad, up, down, whether I'm sad or happy, I know that I'm still motivated to do what I need to do. I know my role, and again, going from a leasing agent to now the sales and leasing manager, obviously my roles have changed, but the motivation to succeed and do well and just be the best that I can be has never ever changed, and that will never change, to be honest. So that's been quite easy.
Yeah, I think in real estate as well, it's quite difficult to stay motivated sometimes.
Yeah, it can be. Look, there's times where it's gonna be super, super low. And I say it all the time to people, especially here in Dubai, the highs are high, the lows are low. Mm-hmm. Everything is magnified by 100. What happens and it's negative or bad is a lot worse than what you think it is, and even the good stuff is a lot better than what you actually think it is. Yeah. So you just gotta ride the wave and stay focused, stay on track, trust the process, you know. But yeah, that's super important.
Ride the wave, baby. And what has been the most rewarding aspect of your role? Similar to the last question, I guess.
Yeah, my role now is, and the rewarding part for me is literally seeing people that have joined with minimal or no experience and some of them with experience. People, you know, we take it for granted. You know, I've been in Dubai a long time now, 10 years. Mm-hmm. Making that move and moving so far away from loved ones, friends and families and everything that you love and know, it's not a joke. It's a big deal. Mm-hmm. So having and playing my part in not only bringing people over because they're coming on our say-so,
yeah.
You know, they're interviewing with you, they're interviewing with me, and they're making their decision based on the things that we tell them, that's a big responsibility in itself.
100%.
So then to make sure that they come here and they perform and they're happy,
mm-hmm.
and they're generating revenue, that's super rewarding when it happens, you know. And our aim and our goal with everyone that joins Dacha is to make sure that they're joining for the right reasons,
mm-hmm.
they're coming at the right time for them. And then when they're here, that's our responsibility to make sure that they, you know, they take their career to the next level and they sit there and go, do you know what? Yeah, I made the move to Dubai. Yes, I moved 4,500 miles away from my friends and family, but it was the right decision. And these guys are the ones that, you know, pointed me in the right direction, held my hand when I needed to, kicked me up the arse when I needed to. but I got there and I'm happy.
Yeah, no, 100%. And looking back over the last 8 years, what do you say, is there anything that you would do differently?
No, I really don't think there is. And I hope that doesn't sound arrogant. It's not supposed to be, but there's nothing that I would change. I'm happy for everything that's happened. There's been some really, really good times. There's been some real, real bad times. I mean, even before I joined Dacha, you know, the difficulties that I had for my first year and a half, I wouldn't wish on anybody. It was tough, but I certainly wouldn't change it.
Mm-hmm.
Character building, and it sounds all cheesy and cliche, but I really wouldn't change a thing.
Yeah.
If these things didn't happen, it wouldn't have molded me into the person I am now. It wouldn't have allowed me to help the people that I've helped in the way that I do. So I genuinely don't think I would change a single thing.
Yeah, and touching on like the first year, I think the first year and a half is definitely the most challenging part about moving over to Dubai.
Yeah, the first year and a half in Dubai the first part of your journey here in Dubai can be difficult. I think the settling in period for most people is a lot longer than what they, one, expect,
mm-hmm.
and two, sadly, that they're told. It's not a 2 or 3 week process.
No.
Where, you know, it's not like moving from one part of the UK to another where everything remains the same.
Mm-hmm.
Same bank accounts, same cars, same friends, same restaurants, same roads, everything changes. So I think the process of settling in and making sure that your feet are under the table and you feel like it's at home, you're earning the money that you want to earn, you've got your new circle of friends, you understand mm-hmm. the road, the locations, the floor plans, the real estate process, it's probably a 6 to 8, maybe 8 to 10 month process.
100%.
I think anyone who tells you any different than that is probably telling
porkies.
Not to say that it can't happen soon. Now, of course, we've got brokers here that have hit the ground running from month one and month two and settled in incredibly well.
Mm-hmm.
But more times out of 10, it's a slightly longer process than that. So.
Yeah, no, I 100% agree with you. And what advice would you give to somebody who's brand new to Dubai, never done sales before, and starting out in real estate?
Okay, what advice would I give? I think be patient,
mm-hmm.
for sure. Don't even necessarily choose a company, but choose a manager or a leader. I don't like to be called a manager, but choose a leader rather than the company, and be prepared to work really, really hard. There's
yeah.
a lot of sacrifices that have to happen in your first period, as not even just in real estate, when you're moving to Dubai, I think, there's a lot of sacrifices. It's very easy to get sucked into the lifestyle and the fancy cars, the watches, the restaurants, the bars, the clubs and the rest of it. I think just stay humble, keep your feet on the ground, be prepared to work hard. It's business over brunch. And trust the process. Again, so cliche, but it couldn't be more legit. Like
yeah.
you have to trust the process, and whatever company and whatever leader you're under or you're working with, should I say, you have to trust them.
Yeah.
And if you can trust their way of working and trust that they're the right person to get the best out of you and to help you take your career to the next level, then you're in a good place.
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah, for sure.
And a little bit of a personal one, but what are your both professional and personal goals for the next couple of years?
Okay. Professional goals, I think the aim here at Dacha is just to organic. You hear me say it all the time, and I've said it a million times, and I think I've said it a million times just in this this little video. But the organic growth of Dacha has always been super important for us as a company, and there's no change there. We want to organically grow to make sure that we have the best agents. Mm-hmm. We provide the best service. We're not perfect.
No.
We don't claim to be, but we try our best and we do the best we can. And I think that's the aim moving forward. Mm-hmm. I just want to make sure that we continue to grow the business in the best possible way at the best time, mm-hmm. organically, and make sure that, you know, our brokers are in good positions and we're focusing very much on the brokers that we have here, rather than just recruiting a bunch of brokers all the time. We just want to make sure that the brokers that are here are generating revenue, having fun, and providing a good service. Off the back of that, the company continues to grow, and we go on to bigger and better things. Who knows? From a personal level, I just want to make sure that I'm happy, I'm healthy, I'm earning. I've got a lovely family, my wife, my two boys. For as long as we're happy and healthy, then there's not really much more I can ask. So we keep it moving.
Amazing. Well, thank you for sitting down with me.
You're very welcome.
And congratulations on 8 years.
Thank you.
There'll be many more years to come.
Get less for murder. But it's all good. No, it's been a pleasure. It's been good fun. And I certainly wouldn't change it for the world.
Brilliant.